from last night. This is swimming action from the Taiwan Sport University Arena. This is in New Taipei City. There you see some of the fans on hand last night. First up, the women's 800 meter freestyle final. This race features the top five finishers from the 1500 meters held earlier here in Taipei. That includes Simona Quadrella from Italy, who won gold. She's in lane six, as well as Sarah Kohler. She won the silver. She is in lane four. And Kohler right now with the lead over Evans. And as they make their way now to the final touch, well ahead of Universiade record time, Quadarella of Italy will win the gold medal, her second of the games. Sarah Kohler of Germany will win her second silver. And there you see that Universiade record time of 8 minutes, 20.54 seconds. There, the final touch for the Italian. Now the men's 100 meter butterfly. In lane four, Andriy Klopsov. He's of Ukraine, won a bronze earlier in the 50 meter butterfly. And in lane five, Henrique de Souza of Brazil tied Klopsov. This one is tight right to the wall. And touching first. Down in lane eight, Alexander Sedovnikov of Russia, in a time of 51.81 seconds, will win the gold medal. Klopsov of Ukraine, the silver. And De Souza of Brazil, the bronze. This is the women's 200 meter freestyle. Shoban Hoey of Hong Kong, already a gold medal winner in the 100 meter freestyle. She touches first. There you see her just ahead of Universiade record time. And it's another record here tonight in the pool. Shoban Hoey of Hong Kong, China, in a time of 156.71, sets a Universiade record. Catherine Drabeau of the United States will win silver, and Arina Openysheva of Russia, the bronze. Now, a quick sprint, the 50 meter women's backstroke. Hannah Stevens in lane five won a silver earlier in the 100 meter backstroke. While Maria Kamineva, she is in lane three, has two silvers already here in Taipei. It is extremely tight as they make their way towards the finish. Easy to call it. Who's going to reach first? It's actually two athletes. It's a tie. Kira Toussaint of the Netherlands and Alexandra Deloof of the United States, in equal 28.07 second times, will win gold medals. Hannah Stevens of the United States will win the bronze. And there you see in that splash of water, Toussaint and Deloof coming up with gold. Here is the men's 200 meter backstroke. In lane four, Danas Rapsis of Lithuania won a gold medal in the 200 meter freestyle and a bronze in the 100 meter backstroke. While Kosuke Hagino, he is in lane three. He won a gold in the men's 200 meter individual medley and also in the 4x200 meter freestyle relay. He's also a past four-time Olympic medalist. Touching first, it's Rapsis winning his second gold here in Taipei. Austin Katz will win the silver for the United States, and Roman Lauren of Russia in lane one will claim the bronze medal. There you see the Lithuanian winning his second gold. This is the men's 50 meter breaststroke. Andrew Wilson in lane two. He tied Ilya Shamanovich of Belarus. He's in lane four. They both won gold medals in the 100-meter breaststroke here in Taipei. As they push towards the wall, it'll be Shamanovich of Belarus winning another gold in a time of 27.39 seconds. Erik Skagius of Sweden, the silver. And Schwindelschlag of Germany, the bronze. That is the Taipei Arena right next to the main stadium, the site of athletics here. We'll go back to last night. First up, the women's 400-meter hurdles. And there you see the start list. And they are away. In lane three, Joanna Linkiewicz of Poland. She's the defending gold medalist from Guangzhou. And as they make their way down the back straight. And through the turn, there you see Ayumide Folarunso of Italy. And she pulls away. Linkiewicz trying to catch her, but she won't. The Italian will win the gold medal in a time of 55.63 seconds. Linkiewicz will finish second. And third, Kolonchenko of Ukraine. Now to the men's high jump. This is Xiang Chun-Xian of Chinese Taipei, and he is good. That's at 2 meters 26. He would later fail three times at 2 meters 29. Now to Marco Fassinotti of Italy. He's good there. That's a jump of 2 meters 29. Now to equal that, this is Falk Weindrich of Germany. And he clears the bar, and that'll be a gold medal. The German will claim gold over Marco Fassinotti of Italy. And there you see the two athletes proudly waving their flags. They're the starters to the line in the men's 1500 meters. Timo Benitz of Germany. He was 23rd at the recent World Championships in London. You can see Alexis Miet of France there, now second. As they make their way down the final straight, Bennett's with a push here as he will pass Miet. Jonathan Davies of Great Britain making a late push, but Miet will hold him off, but they can't catch Bennett's in a time of 3 minutes 43.45 seconds. He will win the gold medal over Miet and Davies. Here is the women's 400 meters. We have the defending gold and silver medalists from Guangzhou in 2015. Justine Palfreman of South Africa won the gold. And there you see Malgorzata Holub. She won the silver, looking to turn her fortune here in Taipei. And she has a solid lead. A late push, but Palfreman just can't catch her. Malgorzata Holub of Poland wins gold just ahead of Justine Palfreman of South Africa. Bianca Razor of Romania wins the bronze. Up next, the women's 800 meters. As they come out of the stagger, down the back straight. On the left, you see Dokas Adjok won gold in the 1500 meters in Guangzhou. That race is still to come here in Taipei. Now down the back straight, Rose Almanza of Cuba pulls away to win gold easily. Olga Lyakova just passes Adjok at the line for silver. And there you see Lyakova, the silver medalist here at the 29th Universiad. There you're looking at Ryoma Yamamoto here in the men's triple jump. Just got back from the World Championships in London. And that is a jump for him of 16 meters 80. Now Hugh Zango of Burkina Faso. He is the defending silver medalist at Universiad. His sixth attempt, 16.97 meters. That's a personal best. Now from Azerbaijan, this is Nazim Babayev. That jump is good. His final jump, 16.76 meters. His best was his first, 17.01, as you see there. And that will propel him to a gold medal here in the men's triple jump. We now move to the men's 400 meters. In lane three, the defending gold medalist, Ludley Santos Aquino of the Dominican Republic. As they head down towards the finish line, there you see him, Santos Aquino, a late charge from the Cuban Leske, but Santos Aquino will hold him off to win the gold medal in a season best time of 45.24 seconds. Leske also a season best, silver, while Rafael Omelko win the bronze. Quickly now to the women's javelin. There you saw Jenny Kangas of Finland. This is her second Universiad. And there you see the throw from Marina Sato of Japan. It would be a personal best, 62.37 meters. This is Marcelina Witek of Poland. Her fifth throw, this too a personal best, 63.31 meters. And that would be the best throw on the day. A gold medal for Marcelina Witek of Poland. Now to the final event in the men's decathlon. You see it well out in front, Aaron Booth of New Zealand. He came in fourth in points to this final race. Kyle Cranston leading, 87 points ahead of Juuso Hassi of Finland and 112 points of third place Maxim Anderlots of Belarus. Booth trying to put himself into medal contention. Has a really solid run here in the men's 1500. Second in this race would be James Turner of Canada. There you see Booth and Turner. And the final results, Cranston will win gold, Hassi the silver, and Booth takes bronze. Now we switch to volleyball. This is the women's quarterfinal matchup between Chinese Taipei and Argentina. Packed house here as we get underway. The defense again there from Chinese Taipei. That one will go long and tie things up 1-1 here early. Now to set point in the first, Chinese Taipei serving for the set, and that one will just catch the back line. Chinese Taipei wins the opening set, 25-13. Now 5-3 in the second. Vera for that back set to Castiglione, Chinese Taipei can't handle it, so that's point Argentina. Now 17-8, Chinese Taipei in front. Good rally here both ways. Back set there, tip Argentina again, able to recover. And that one will finally go off the Argentinian block and out off that attack from Wu. Now 22-13. Quick back set from Curtola to Bulgarella. And that kill will score for Argentina. Now to set point. And Wu with another kill. Chinese Taipei now up 2-0. Move to the third. Argentina serving up 6-4. That attack blocked by Argentina. And the rally continues. And that one from Garcia goes long. Point to Chinese Taipei. Now 12-10, Argentina in front. Great dig there from Espergen on the Chinese Taipei tip. And from the back row, that one blocked by Argentina. Chinese Taipei can't recover. Timeout called. Now 19 all. And Lin there with the set for Wen. And that kill puts Chinese Taipei up by one. And from the right side here, Argentina will tie it up at 20. As these teams go back and forth, we now go to match point. Kosar off the Chinese Taipei block. And here Tsang doesn't get all of it, but just enough, it lands in. That will end it. Chinese Taipei off to the semifinal against Japan as they beat Argentina 3-0. 25-13, 25-15, 25-22. This crowd ecstatic here in Taipei, so they will take on Japan. The other semifinal will feature Russia taking on Ukraine. There an aerial shot of the Tam Kang University Memorial Gym. Weightlifting, there you see the medal standing so far here in weightlifting. The Democratic People's Republic of Korea leading the way. And this is the women's over 90 kilogram class. And there are the athletes.
Zhou Yunlin from Chinese Taipei.
There is Chung Yun Ling of Chinese Taipei. First up, we'll take a look at Mercy Brown of Great Britain. The bronze of the 2016 European Championships. She would lift 98 kilograms in the snatch. This is an attempt at 136 in the clean and jerk. She lifted 125 kilos and 134 in her first two attempts.
Push! Got it, got it, got it, got it, come on! Good girl, take your time.
It's time ticking down here for her. She will push and get under that bar. A strong lift. She's excited about that one. Very excited. Mercy Brown, 136 kilograms.
She's on the way to 138 kilograms.
Now from Thailand, this is Pulsabsakul. She lifted 120 kilograms in the snatch. This is an attempt at 150 in the clean and jerk. She's a two-time bronze medalist at the World Championships back in 2013 and 2014. Doesn't waste any time. Good lift there. Pulsabsakul.
Good lift.
Her total will be 270. Now it is Kim Kuk Hyang of the Democratic People's Republic of Korea. Won a silver in the over 75 kilogram class back at the Rio Olympics 1 year ago. She lifted 132 kilograms in the snatch. This is an attempt at 167 in the clean and jerk. She was good already at 160 kilograms in the clean and jerk. Takes her time here and powers it up, and Kim A huge lift, 167 kilograms, much to the delight of her coach. She will win the gold medal, as you see the replay here. Her total of 299 kilograms, 29 ahead of Pulsabsakul of Thailand. In third place, Mercy Brown. There you see it, 234 kilograms in the women's, over 90 kilos. Quarterfinal action in men's football from the Fujian Catholic University Stadium in New Taipei City. This matchup features Mexico and Ukraine, 31 degrees at kickoff. And there you see the two teams, Mexico in green, Ukraine in their traditional blue and yellow. And here in the third minute, Fatorochenko tries to pass it back, and it's intercepted. Pablo Hutt of Mexico steals the ball and will deposit it behind Ivan Seletsky. So in the third minute on a turnover, there you see Hutt jumping in on that ball and sliding with the outside of the right foot. Mexico up 1-0. Now to the 35th minute. Ukraine worked the ball back to the middle of the field and that left-footed attempt goes wide. So as we near halftime, 1-0 it remains. Now into the second half. An opportunity there headed over the bar. Ukraine trying to find the equalizer. Now in the 85th, Kotliar lobs one into the box. A bit of a scramble. But Pastorena will ultimately get his hands on it. You'll see the replay here. Kotliar there with a chance to the left foot. But Castorena easily able to corral it. Now late here in the second half, Ukraine trying to find the equalizer, but a nice chip there from Martinez. That'll spring Quiñones, and he will find Leon. And Mexico in the 89th minute up 2-0. There you see that perfect pass that Leon can move in on. And he fires it home. Now in stoppage time. That is it. Mexico off to the semifinal. They score on two of their three shots on goal. Ukraine had eight but could not get one past the keeper. The Taipei Arena. One site of basketball here at the 29th Summer Universiad. This is a quarterfinal matchup featuring Canada and host Chinese Taipei. You see there a huge crowd on hand for this quarterfinal. Canada will win the opening tip. Penetration there from Kelly Ring, but it won't drop. There will be a tie up here, and the possession arrow favors Chinese Taipei. Now Wang will go baseline, and that reverse is good. Chinese Taipei up early, 2-0. Now Canada, skip pass over to Treyer. She'll get it to Fogg, who kicks it back out. And Crozon will knock down the three for the Canadians. 17-16, Canada ahead. And a nice take there, and Huang will kiss it off the window and in as time expires in the first quarter. Midway through the second quarter, Lin will deliver here, and the three drops. Chinese Taipei building their lead up by nine. But then Nunez will find Kirkpatrick on the wing, and that three falls. Canada closes the lead to six. It would remain that way at half. Now a 12-point lead for Chinese Taipei. Elbow jumper here for Cheng is good. Canada calls a timeout, trying to talk things over. Canada down 14. And Traer with a nice look down low to kiss Russ. And she'll finish the layup. Now Chen waits for the screen. And just inside the elbow, she'll hit that pull-up jumper. Restores the lead to 10. Into the fourth quarter. Chinese Taipei up by 9. And Low left wide open for 3, and she'll drain it. Canada would narrow the lead to 5. Skip pass here to Nofuente, who will attack, and she'll find Kiss Rusk for the layup. Canada closes it to 3. Chinese Taipei now up 4. Chinese Taipei almost lose the handle here, but it ends up in the hands of Chen. Three-pointer is good. Lead now 7 for Chinese Taipei. And as time ticks down, that basket no good anyway. Canada cannot catch up. Chinese Taipei, with their huge crowd on hand, will go to the semifinal, a 76-67 win over Canada. They will face Australia. And the other semi will feature Japan and Russia. Chinese Taipei with a huge victory here in women's quarterfinal basketball action.